Would you please stand? Our opening hymn for this Ascension Day is hymn number 483. Hymn 483. In the red book of a common prayer on page 355. Alleluia, Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Continuing on the next page. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High. Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty God, whose blessed Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, ascended far above all heavens that he might fill all things, mercifully give us faith to perceive that, according to his promise, he abides with his church on earth even to the end of the ages. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God in glory everlasting. Please be seated for the reading of Holy Scripture.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In the first book, Theophilus, I wrote about all that Jesus did and taught from the beginning until the day when he was taken up to heaven, after giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles whom he had chosen. After his suffering, he presented himself alive to them by many convincing proofs, appearing to them during 40 days and speaking about the kingdom of God. While staying with them, he ordered them not to leave Jerusalem, but to wait there for the promise of the Father. This, he said, is what you have heard from me. For John baptized with water, but you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit not many days from now. So, when they had come together, they asked him, Lord, is this the time when you'll restore the kingdom to Israel? He replied, it is not for you to know the times or periods that the Father has set by his own authority, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you. And you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, in all Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. When he had said this, as they were watching, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him out of their sight. While he was going, and they were gazing up toward heaven, suddenly, two men in white robes stood by them. They said, Men of Galilee, why do you stand looking up toward heaven? This Jesus, who has been taken up from you into heaven, will come in the same way as you saw him go into heaven. The word of the Lord. The psalm for today is Psalm 93, found in your bulletin insert. We will recite the psalm together in unison. The Lord is King. He has put on splendid apparel. The Lord has put on his apparel and girded himself with strength. He has made the whole world so sure that it cannot be moved. Ever since the world began, your throne has been established. You are from everlasting. The waters have lifted up, O Lord. The waters have lifted up their voice. The waters have lifted up their pounding waves. Mightier than the sound of many waters, mightier than the breakers of the sea, mightier is the Lord who dwells on high. Your testimonies are very sure, and holiness adorns your house, O Lord, forever and forevermore. The second reading is from the letter of Paul to the Ephesians. I have heard of your faith in the Lord Jesus, and your love toward all the saints. And for this reason, I do not cease to give thanks for you as I remember you in my prayers. I pray that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation as you come to know him, so that with the eyes of your heart enlightened, you may know what is the hope to which he has called you, what are the riches of his glorious inheritance among the saints, and what is the immeasurable greatness of his power for us who believe, according to the working of his great power. God put this power to work in Christ when he raised him from the dead and seated him at his right hand in the heavenly places, far above all rule and authority and power and dominion, and above every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the age to come. And he has put all things under his feet, and has made him the head over all things for the church, which is his body, the fullness of him who fills all in all. The word of the Lord.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures. And he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Messiah is to suffer and to rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance and forgiveness of sins is to be proclaimed in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses to all these things. And see, I am sending upon you what my Father promised. So stay here in the city until you have been clothed with power from on high." Then he led them out as far as Bethany, and lifting up his hands, he blessed them. While he was blessing them, he withdrew from them and was carried up into heaven. And they worshiped him and returned to Jerusalem with great joy, and they were continually in the temple blessing God. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Please be seated. Well, good evening. Thanks for coming out on this, the 40th day of the season of Easter. As you heard in that first reading from Acts, Jesus in his post-resurrection appearances and teachings runs for 40 days. 40 days is an important number in the Bible. 40 days and 40 nights, Noah is in the ark. 40 days are what we celebrate, walk through the desert with during the Lenten season. And when we arrive at Easter, 40 days has its place too, in that Jesus is with us or with the disciples after his resurrection for 40 days. Then he ascends into heaven. And 10 days later is when we celebrate Pentecost Sunday. So we have one more Sunday in between now and then before we get to Pentecost. So I was thinking about Ascension Day. I was talking to Kathy right before we came in and looking at this beautiful window we have, which honors the ascension of our Lord, his rising up. I told Kathy that technically it should be the disciples standing there as he's going up into heaven, but it does mention both those stories. Well, in the Acts story we heard that there are two men that appear. These are images of angels. So the angels are there to speak to the disciples who are looking up into heaven as Jesus ascends. And so we get a good image of them. Kathy said to me, that could be any image you want it to be. I think what she meant was it could be the resurrection, it could be the transfiguration. I read it when she said that she thought those guys could be anybody they wanted to be, but I said they got wings. They have to be angels. So therefore, luckily, the story of the ascension has the angels in it, and so we have that there. But, you know, the image of Jesus ascending into heaven, the thing that's been on my brain all day, and I'll share this with you, and we'll move on with our worship and our prayer for this Ascension Day. The thing that's been running through my head today is that image of Jesus ascending into heaven. I mean, I'll be honest with you. For all my time, all my life, I tend to think of the moment of the Ascension as Jesus going away from us. He's risen from the dead. He's present and appearing to the disciples. He's preaching. He's sharing a meal with them. He's showing them his wounds. He's doing all of these things that bring about the proof of his physical resurrection. And then on the 40th day, he ascends to disappear up into the heavenly realm. Well, I was reading some commentary, and it put into my brain another image of that for us that sort of forces us to step out of our sort of rational enlightenment brain and the way we think about earth and heaven, and to step into a different view that probably was more prevalent at the time of Jesus in the Bible and in the early church, definitely through the Middle Ages, all the way up to the Enlightenment in any case. And that is that the way the world viewed the heavens and the earth in those ancient days wasn't exactly the same way we do here in the Rocket City, meaning that we look up and we see space, and we know that when you get on the rocket ships and you go up and away out of this world and into some far and distant place in that outer universe. I think that's the way we tend to view Jesus as well, getting on the rocket ship and ascending up into heaven to go be with God in some distant, far-off planet where God resides, looking at the earth from a great distance. But I think the way that the early church, as well as those folks who followed the church up through the time of Paul, and as well as the Jews did before that, at the time of Jesus and before that, their view of heaven and earth was more of an understanding of dimensions, perhaps, There's the earthly world we live in, and then there's the spiritual world, which isn't distant from us in some faraway place, but is here with us in the present, all around us. If you think about the way the idea of the world was in those times before, I don't know, the 17th or 18th century, that idea that there was always the presence of the spiritual with you everywhere you were. And interestingly enough, as smart and rational and as scientific as we are today, we still believe that there are things present with us in the physical world that we don't see. I mean, I always like to laugh and think about when I had to go through my test to go to seminary. I had to go through this mental health test, and they asked me a whole lot of different questions. And one of those questions was, do you ever talk to someone that no one else can see? And this was a mental health question, so I'm sure if I'd put yes all the time, they would have said, this guy does not get to go to seminary. You need to send him to a psychiatrist immediately. But I thought, I'm taking this test before I go to seminary, and of course I talk to someone that I talk to all the time and can't be seen. That's sort of the prayer life with Jesus and with God. And I think to myself, all of us who attend the church somewhere, no matter where you are in your spiritual life or what you believe and think about when it comes to the church, somewhere along the way, you are in contact with something that is not within the physical realm of viewing, right? It's in the spiritual dimension. It's somewhere beyond that. So without getting us off track and talking about dimensions and spiritual things and earthly things, the important thing to think about is when Jesus ascends up into heaven, he is moving into that realm that isn't distant from us, but is actually closer to us than it was before. I mean, think about it this way with our rational, enlightened brains. If Jesus is in his human resurrected form, he can only exist amongst those people that he's close to. If he moves into the spiritual realm, if he ascends up into heaven, as the Bible says, then he has the ability to be everywhere in the world, from the farthest distance to right next to you when you need him the most. So I like to think that this moment in the time of Easter, when we think about Jesus' incredible, amazing resurrection from the dead and what that does in the world and how it changes the world, I think that the ascension is important as well, because it makes sure we understand that in that resurrection, Jesus is now even closer to us than he ever was before. And Jesus, in his ascent to be with God in the spiritual realm, is not in a great faraway place, but is actually closer to us than he's ever been. He's in our hearts. And he will return again in that form that we understand from reading the New Testament, that we understand from the promise that Jesus has died, he has risen, Jesus will come again. But in the present, while Jesus is in the ascended form, he is right with us everywhere we go. And I think that makes Ascension Day so important in the Easter season, to help us think about our relationship with Jesus and the closeness we actually have because of his going up to be with God, and by going up to be with God, being able to be close with you and me wherever we find ourselves, in the good times, in the bad times, times when the sun is shining, in the times when it seems very dark. There's no place we can go now, since Jesus has ascended, that Jesus cannot be with us. And that makes this day nearly as good as Easter. And here we are, just a handful of folks to remember it. Well, we'll be talking about it on this upcoming Sunday. Ascension Day is an important part of our Easter season. And this is the 40th day in which we remember and proclaim Jesus ascended, Jesus being with us even closer than ever before. Amen.
Prayers of the people are Form 4 in the Red Book of Common Prayer on page 388. Let us pray for the church and for the world. Grant, Almighty God, that all who confess your name may be united in your truth, live together in your love, and reveal your glory in the world. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Guide the people of this land and of all the nations in the ways of justice and peace, that we may honor one another and serve the common good. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Give us all a reverence for the earth as your own creation, that we may use its resources rightly in the service of others and to your honor and glory. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Bless all whose lives are closely linked with ours, and grant that we may serve Christ in them and love one another as he loves us. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Comfort and heal all those who suffer in body, mind, or spirit. Give them courage and hope in their troubles, and bring them the joy of your salvation. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We commend to your mercy all who have died, that your will for them may be fulfilled, and we pray that we may share with all your saints in your eternal kingdom. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. Hasten, O Father, the coming of your kingdom. Grant that we, your servants who now live by faith, may with joy behold your Son at his coming in glorious majesty. Even Jesus Christ, our only mediator and advocate, in whose name we pray. Amen. Amen. Turning to page 360 in the Book of Common Prayer, let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. The peace of the Lord be always with you. the beauty of midday services that I have nothing to announce. So join in the offertory hymn and walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us as an offering and a sacrifice to God. Our worship continues with the Great Thanksgiving Eucharistic Prayer B, which can be found in the Book of Common Prayer on page 367. Page 367. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and good and thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, through your dearly beloved Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. After his glorious resurrection, he openly appeared to his disciples and in their sight ascended into heaven to prepare a place for us, that where he is, there we might also be, and reign with him in glory. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation, in the calling of Israel to be your people, in your word spoken through the prophets, and above all in the word made flesh, Jesus your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he'd given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory. And we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country, wherewith the ever-blessed Virgin Mary, St. Thomas, and all your saints, we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Hallelujah, Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us. Therefore let us keep the feast. These are the gifts of God for the people of God. Let's give thanks for the gifts we've received this evening using the post-communion prayer on page 365 in the Book of Common Prayer. Page 365. Let us pray. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. And you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. God the Father, who has given to his Son the name above every name, strengthen you to proclaim Jesus the Christ, the Son of God. God the Son, our great high priest, who has passed into the heavens, clothe you with power from on high. God the Holy Spirit, who pours out abundant gifts upon the church, make you faithful followers of the risen Christ. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you this Ascension Day and remain with you always. Amen.
To love and serve the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia.